During a Teachers' Day party held today at the Uganda Museum, teachers from the five divisions of Kampala decried decreasing numbers of people who show interest in the teaching profession. They attribute this to teachers' welfare and thus asked that government hikes the efforts to solve this situation in a bid to save their profession.
Much as teachers are doing a great work, but the way the community perceives teachers in terms of status in the community, you see these are low-income earners. So even when they are talking to their children, they will tell them, you study hard, become an engineer, become a doctor, become this, because those are the paying jobs.
Payment to the science teachers, it is something good. It has been enhanced by the government, and we are told that the arts will follow suit. So people have evoked that negativity because they think it's a low-paying job.
When you tell children that how many of you would like to become teachers and you see nobody putting up their hand? How many would like to become doctors? Very many. I think this time has come that teachers should be respected. And once they are respected, they are living very well, the conditions of living are good. I think it will encourage, it will inspire the students to join.
Themed the teachers we need for the education we want, the global imperative to reverse the teacher shortage, teachers were encouraged to develop along with the new trends in the education systems in the country. Relatedly, as the world marks the International Teachers' Day, teachers still complain of unfriendly working conditions, among them being overworked, underpaid and undervalued, something that has demoralized a big number of them.
Usually for teachers, because it's a mental occupation which involves a constant use of the mind, so basically somebody needs to be having peace of mind. Of course, this comes with the kind of environment and society we live in. Teachers have the same challenges of fees, transport, feeding. So when the conditions are quite challenging, they find it difficult to concentrate. So it becomes a problem.
Early this year, the science teachers were able to secure themselves a pay rise of 100%. But according to the arts teachers, this was unfair and only meant to demotivate them.
Even today, when our national chairperson was giving a speech in front of Mr. Museveni, who was the chief guest, that speech, if you heard it very well, he emphasized the issue of the government working on the salaries of the arts teachers.
The situation is not any better for the lecturers at higher institutions of learning. Edwin Napakol, the chairperson of Makerere University Business School Academic Staff Association, says the university lecturers have made several appeals to have their salaries fully enhanced, but in vain.
So when the conditions are quite challenging, they find it difficult to concentrate. So it becomes a problem. Other universities, we've had major issues over the enhancement, where there's been enhancement up to about 20% have been fully enhanced. So it's still a challenge for the lecturers, senior lecturers, the teaching assistants and assistant lecturers. There's not been full enhancement.
Napakol further asks the government to fulfill its promises of ensuring that all teachers at different levels earn decently, as well as enjoy improved working conditions.
A teacher who is well motivated even goes the extra mile to do much, much more to ensure that the country gets well-rounded and well-groomed and skilled individuals.
Rachel Nachuala and Derek Asaba for the news.